Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Buckeye News Update here on Lantern TV. I'm Franz Ross. The men's basketball team was away this weekend for a Valentine's Day road game in East Lansing against Michigan State. Even with the return of recently suspended sophomore forward Mark Loving, the Buckeyes lost 59-56 from a late three by, you guessed it, Spartan guard Denzel Valentine. With the hoops away, the men's hockey team hosted Wisconsin for a weekend series. Our hockey reporter Evan Simkowitz has your post-game report from the Schottenstein Center.
After defeating the Wisconsin Badgers 2-1 on Friday night, it was the visiting Badgers that salvaged a 3-2 victory to split the series and earn their first Big Ten victory of the season. When a team can split a series against a talented club, holding them to just 28 shots the night after a victory, you might assume they'd be feeling pretty good about their game. But the mood after the loss was one of disappointment.
You know, to come out and get the early lead, that's exactly what you want to do, but you know, you tip your cap to them because you know they're going to work. They're hungry. They want to get the first win in the league for them. You know, I talked to our guys after, you got to play desperate. And we talked about playoff hockey, and to me, that's certainly a different version of playoff hockey than I understand.
Just pride, you know. You got to play desperate hockey all the time. You know, we want to go in the tournament, obviously, with some confidence. And, you know, it was a great opportunity for us tonight to get the first sweep of the year, and we just came up short.
With tournament play looming, the Buckeyes shift their attention to next week's home-and-home series versus the rival Michigan Wolverines, who we last saw here in Columbus rout the Buckeyes by a score of 10-6. We'll have your coverage of that game and the rest of the Buckeyes season here on Lantern TV. From the Schottenstein Center, for Lantern TV, I'm Evan Simkowitz.
This Friday, the Ohio Union turned into the United Nations with the annual Taste of OSU. Ohio State ethnic and cultural organizations gathered together for dancing and food tasting. Lantern TV reporter Amanda Vaughn has more.
On Friday night, more than 30 of OSU's international and ethnic clubs gathered in the Union for the 19th annual Taste of OSU.
Culture, a full stomach, and just experience, you know, other people's food, and then also hopefully like clothing and customs.
We hope that people just realize what an international and diverse community that they live in. I mean, there are so many cultures, so many heritages from all around the world here.
We have over 6,800 international students, and so it's really exciting for them to have the opportunity to really share where they're from. Friends, especially for domestic students, to learn a little bit about the rest of the world, at least become curious enough to want to learn more.
It's a really big deal. This is our third year, and as a really small country and as a small organization, it's really great to be able to represent such a small sect in such a large event.
We've been working on this pretty much ever since April of last year. A lot of preparation with student organizations, with organizations on campus such as Student Dining Services and the Office of International Affairs.
The estimated 5,000 attendees experienced performances and food samples from the various cultural groups represented on campus. For Lantern TV, I'm Amanda Vaughn.
With temperatures nearing zero, it's been a frigid past few days here in Columbus. Our meteorologist Russell Bird is going to fill you in if the cold will continue in the days ahead.
Yeah, Franz, it's going to stay real cold outside with a high of 18 degrees and a low of 17. Not much change there, but what we're really looking at is that snow we're going to see later this afternoon moving into tonight around midnight, around 2 to 4 inches accumulation. But to the south, they're getting a lot more than us, so we actually have it pretty easy compared to the rest. If we have a look at tomorrow, warming up to a high of 25 degrees and a low of 9, it's going to stay pretty chilly, below freezing, west winds at 10 miles per hour. Let's have a look at Wednesday. We're going to be at, 18 degrees, real cold outside, and a low of 0. West wind at 10 to 15 miles per hour, real chilly outside. And if we have a look at Thursday, wow, 10 degrees for the high and a low of negative 2. So very chilly outside on Thursday. Make sure you bundle up. Mostly cloudy skies. That's it for the weather. Back to you guys in the studio.
There will be an expanded weather story on the continuing chill by John Banghoff in Thursday's Buckeye News Now. That's all for this show. However, you can find more of today's stories online at thelantern.com. Also, be sure to visit The Lantern and Lantern TV on Twitter, Facebook, or on Instagram for more news and sports updates. Thanks for watching.